You mentioned during the last hearing that you never knew Congressman Niel Tupas. Am I right?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Where are you from?
I'm from Iloilo, Your Honor.
Iloilo. Where in Iloilo?
I'm from La Paz, Iloilo City,
La Paz, Your Honor. Iloilo. And you are fully aware that Congressman Tupas is a congressman of Iloilo?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Are you married?
Yes, Your Honor.
May I know your middle name, Madam Witness?
My name is Mary. My middle name is Buenaflor.
Buenaflor.
Your right. Honor.
Tika saan po yung mga Buenaflor?
I grew up in Iloilo City, but my father is from Dumangas.
Your father is from Dumangas. Your mother is from?
My mother is from Capiz, but she grew up in Marikina. And then when she married my husband, she went to Iloilo.
What is the name of your parents?
My father's name is Eugenio Buenaflor. My mother's name is Zenaida Buenaflor.
All right.
De La Paz Buenaflor.
Do you know a certain Thelma Salina Buenaflor?
Yes, Your Honor.
Who is she?
She is my auntie, Your Honor.
Do you know of a certain Roberto Obet Buenaflor Armada?
Yes, Your Honor.
Who is he?
He is the son of Thelma.
The son of Thelma. What is the name of the father of Obet?
I honestly do not recall, Your Honor.
You do not know the name of
Tito
your
Hill.
Uncle?
Hill. Oh, there you
sorry. Hill what Armada, is your relationship Honor. With Obet Buenaflor Armada? How are you related to him?
He is my cousin, Your Honor.
He is your cousin. All right. This Roberto Obet Buenaflor Armada became a vice governor of the province of Iloilo. Am I correct?
As I recall, Your Honor.
Who was the governor then?
I do not know, Your Honor.
You do not know?
I was already here, Your Honor, when he ran, so I was not involved in his...
You do not know? Okay, just to refresh your memory, the governor then, when your first cousin was vice governor of Iloilo, the governor then was the father of Congressman Tupas. His name is Governor Niel Tupas Sr.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
All right. So are you acquainted with any member of the Tupas family?
No, Your Honor.
Still no?
You have never met? Personally, I am not acquainted with any of them, Your Honor.
You have never met any brother of... Congressman Tupas?
No, Your Honor.
Never?
I was here since college, Your Honor.
Since college. Where did you study in... where did you take your elementary school?
I took my elementary school in Assumption, Iloilo, Your Honor.
Iloilo. College?
College, I initially took it in UP Visayas, and then I went on to UP Diliman on my third year until I graduated, Your Honor.
So when did you come here in Manila?
That was 1988, Your Honor.
1988. When?
87, Your Honor, sorry. The school year of 1987, Your Honor.
Okay. Do you know of a certain Raul Buboy Tupas?
Personally, no, Your Honor.
Have you heard of him?
I think they were just talking about him before, but I've never really bothered to know about him.
When was the last time you went to Iloilo?
What is the answer of the witness?
I'm trying to recall, Your Honor. The last time I was in Iloilo was during our reunion in high school.
When was that?
In December
of
2011.
Oh, just recently.
Wait, sorry. 2010, Your Honor.
1.5 years ago.
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Your cousin, again, Mr. Obet Benaflor Armada, ran for vice governor in the last 2010 elections. Am I correct?
I believe so, Your Honor.
You believe so? Bakit I believe so?
Because I'm not really that that interested in their whatever they do there, especially in politics. I'm not interested in that.
And again, to refresh your memory, the candidate for, or the running mate of your cousin, your first cousin, was Raul Buboy Tupas, the brother of Congressman Niel Tupas. Am I correct?
If you say so, Your Honor.
If I say so.
I thought nga it was
and,
the
guy.
Sorry.
Unfortunately, both lost during the last 2000 elections, no? For governor and for vice governor. When your cousin ran for vice governor, of course, you know personally your cousin, am I right?
Yes, Your Honor.
Are you close to him?
Not really, Your Honor. We don't see much.
You don't see much. When was the last time you saw your first cousin, vice governor?
I do not recall, Your Honor.
When he ran for vice governor in the year 2004 and in the year 2010, did you help in his campaign?
In the year 2004, yes, Your Honor, we offered to give 3,000 pesos, but in 2010, we did not.
All right. You did not help him in the 2010 election. So do you still stand by your answer that when you were asked that you don't know Congressman Tupas, that you don't know Congressman Tupas?
No, sir.
You haven't seen him even when you were visiting your province in...
No, sir. We were never introduced. I have never seen him.
What about Buboy Tupas?
Same also, sir.
You have never seen any member of the Tupas family?
No, sir.
What about the wife of Congressman Tupas?
Does she frequent
your bank in a PS bank?
I do not know her, sir. I have never seen her.
Miss Tiongson, you are under oath.
Yes, sir. I am under oath.
You're testifying here under your previous oath, and I hope you will not lie.
I am not
because
lying,
records
Your
show
Honor.
That there is an
Miss,
acquaintance.
Let the questioner finish the question before you answer so that it can be well recorded. Into so the record of this proceeding.
Because all that I mentioned to you, the link between your family and the family of Congressman Tupas, talagang obvious na merong acquaintance yung pamilya nyo, magkakilala yung pamilya nyo at yung pamilya ni Tupas. And now you are still denying that you don't know even one member, family member of the Tupas family. It's quite absurd.
I reiterate, Your Honor, I do not know any of them, Your Honor.
All right, let's go to a different topic. Last time around, I requested you to bring the logbook. Did you bring the logbook?
It was not covered by the subpoena, Your Honor.
Yeah.
You were ordered to bring the logbook, if I remember correctly.
Because I remember I asked you a question, if my memory serves me right, that only four persons have access to the vault, no, to the documents, the confidential documents. And when I ask you kung merong logbook yon, nung tinanong kita kung may logbook yon, sinabi mo meron.
Yes, we do have a logbook.
Yes. May I request, Mr. President, if this witness can submit or can bring the logbook of PS Bank?
My recollection is that when that point was discussed, precisely I asked her several questions. And You can either deny or confirm what I ask you. I ask you where those signature cards were being kept. And you said your answer was that they were kept in a steel cabinet. And I ask you again, who has control over that steel cabinet? And your answer was that two officers have control over that steel cabinet. And so I ask, could one of them only open that steel cabinet? And your answer was that no. Then you said the two custodians of the steel cabinet have different keys to open that steel cabinet, then they must both be present to be able to open that steel cabinet. Is that correct?
Yes, sir, partly. Actually, I said that an officer and a customer service assistant may open jointly the vault with the combination, sir.
All right. Jointly.
Yes, sir. The steel cabinet is inside that vault.
Jointly, but yes, they have different numbers.
Yes, sir.
On the combination.
Yes, sir.
Correct. So that neither one of them could open alone.
Yes, sir.
Both of them must open.
Yes, sir.
And then the next question that I asked you was, do you also have access over the contents of that steel cabinet? And you said, yes, but I have to bring the two officers, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
All right. Then, at that point, the gentleman from San Juan asked whether you have a logbook. And your answer was in the affirmative, correct?
Yes, sir.
Then I ordered you, he asked that the logbook be presented to this court, correct?
I do not recall, Your Honor. We will have to review that
and
we will bring it.
I will appeal to the record.
Yes,
I may be mistaken by the sequence of the question. Can you go to the records and find out? Please
check.